Hello, Boerne High School, and welcome to this week's edition of BHNN. I'm Bailey.
And I'm Carson. We're going to get things started off with a special edition of Jeff's Coat,
followed by a Nurse's Corner.
Special.
Hello, and welcome to this weekly edition of Jeff's Coat. My name is Mr. Jeff Coat, and today we're here to talk about something special, all right? I factually know this for sure. People dream. And dreaming is quite an incredible thing, especially when you're deaf. Now listen, stay with me. So, people, whenever they're sleeping, typically, sometimes, rarely, occasionally, talk in their sleep. They talk and they say, "Whoa, hi, how's it going? My name's Jeff." Anyways, stuff like that. But did you know that people who are deaf, they sign, they do their sign language with their hands while they're sleeping? That's a crazy known fact that I know since I'm Mr. Jeffco. That'll be it for all for this week's edition of Mr. Jeff's Coat. Just want to let you guys know that I'm the greatest teacher alive, and that's that. Adios.
Hello, Boerne High School. My name is Donald Garcia, and today I'm joined by
Colin Fisher.
And today we're going to be talking about the cold and the flu. So, the reason why we're going to be talking about the cold and the flu is because, you know, lately, students around the school have been, you know, doing the good old achoo-achoo, ah-ha-ha-ha, the you know, usual around this time of the season. And it's no bueno, you know? Sometimes people might be confused what symptoms they have. Maybe they may think, ugh, me thinky, I have cold. But sometimes they might think, oh, dang, I have the flu, and that's no good. Am I right, Colin?
That's not good.
It's not good. The flu is kind of funky. Wash your hands. So right here, I have a little list of the symptoms of the cold and of the flu, and it shows side-by-side comparison of what has what symptoms and what has the other symptoms. Kind of neat to have. All right, so in case you have a stuffy nose, it's common for a cold to like have a stuffy nose. It's common. You might have just a little nose common, you know? And it's not that fun. And with the flu, it's like sometimes. Sometimes. But it's just more common with the cold just to be stuffy nose. All right? And to have that good old sore throat, it's common as well for the cold to have a sore throat. You know, you might be walking around school and you're like, this one might be, ooh. For the cold, it says for symptoms. For the chest discomfort and cough, so you're feeling that hard, like, and it's hurting. It's not fun. It's hurting, right, Colin? It's hurting.
Wash your hands.
Wash your hands. It's hurting, and it's not fun. For the cold, it's mild to moderate that you might have it. The cold.
I hate coughs.
Hacking coughs, too. Don't you just, you know? Not fun.
I hate it.
It's not fun. It's not fun.
It's never fun.
But with the flu, this might be a bummer, but it might be common that you have chest discomfort. And it can become severe. So if you're like noticing like you're coughing and it's like really rough, like how I was, like, you know, like not fun, then that might be just, it might be the flu. At that point, you might be like, okay, I might need to plan a visit to the good old doctor.
Or if you're at school, come see Nurse Gish.
And she'll give you ice. And she'll send you home probably, because she knows better. She knows better. All right. So, I think that's mostly what I've gotten through here on this good old handy dandy paper.
Wash your hands.
But, just to conclude, you know, it's better to be safe than sorry, you know? But just make sure you know what kind of symptoms are going on around this kind of season. Because it's always good to know what's going on here, 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 and all that jazz. So you're functional, that you can stay in school, be safe, be clean, use your shoulders for coughing, and all that jazz. All right, I think that's enough said from me. I've talked way so much.
Wash your hands.
Wash your hands. Wash your hands. Wash your hands. Bye. Hi, I'm back with girls soccer with Lexi and Crystal. And how did y'all's game go on Tuesday against Canyon Lake?
We won 10-0.
Nice. Who scored the most goals?
Me.
How many did you score?
5.
Nice. And who are y'all playing today?
Wimberly.
Wimberly? And how's that gonna look?
Good, we're gonna win.
Nice.
I'm ready.
Well, thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next week.
Good morning, Greyhounds. I'm Alexis Applegate, and I'm here to give you an update on boys varsity soccer. First are the scores from their most recent games. Antonio won 0-2 on February 4th. Gonzalez lost 3-1 on February 7th. Canyon Lake lost 1-0 on February 11th. Now for a schedule update on boys varsity soccer. The next game is February 14th at Wimberly High School at 7 p.m. Then February 18th is a home game against Gonzalez at 7 p.m. as well. Good luck, Greyhounds!
Thank you everyone for those exquisite softball and soccer updates.
Now we're going to take you to boys and girls basketball.
Hey Greyhounds, it's Ben Phillip here with another basketball update. This Friday, the boys will face the Bandera Bulldogs in a home game. Going into the game, the Hounds are 7-1, and it's a home game, and don't forget, we don't have school on Friday, so if you want to come up and support the Hounds, it is senior night, so we'll be thanking all of our seniors for what they do for the team and everything. So if you want to make the drive up, then you can. The game is at 6:30. Don't forget, no school, so if you want to come, then come, and thanks for watching, guys.
Boys and girls basketball is looking hot, real hot.
Next, we're going to take you to a band update and a Boerne community update.
Hello, Boerne High School. It's Emma Harper bringing you another band update. This is it. Four of our band members are going to state, so wish them the best of luck. Also, on February 24th, we have our solo and ensemble contest, and on April 1st, we have our ULL performance, so good luck to that.
We'll be right back.
And we're back. Thank you for those band updates and those community updates.
Now we're going to take you to a very special Valentine's Day video.
What's up, bud?
How you doing?
Good. How you doing today? To be honest, I'm not good, dude. I'm freaking out. I don't have a date for Valentine's. I'm freaking out, man. I need help. Who are you?
I'm Mr. Valentine's Day, man.
I need your help, Mr. Valentine's Day, man. I don't have a date for Valentine's Day. I'm freaking out, dude.
It's okay. It's okay. Listen, with the power of friendship and love, I'll be able to help you.
Yay.
Yay.
All right, Mr. Valentine.
Wow. Today's your lucky day. There's two lucky women over there.
You got this, Blake.
Okay, awesome. Listen, use the techniques that I told you. Be yourself, be loving, and be sweet, okay? And then you woo any girl in this universe, all right?
All right.
All right. Now go for it. Hunka chunka. You got this.
Wait. What do you say, you two ladies take a real man?
No.
The Valentine. Will you go to Valentine's with me?
Please.
Will you be my Valentine's Day date? I do not have a Valentine's Day date.
Either of you ladies wanna be mine? Be my Valentine?
No, thank you.
God dang it.
Valentine?
Do you wanna be my Valentine?
No.
It's cause you're ugly.
Valentine?
No.
Y'all boys know I can find some ladies for Valentine's Day?
Yeah, dude.
Not here.
What do you say about being my Valentine?
No.
Hey, Doug, you know I can find any ladies for Valentine's Day?
Me, yeah.
There's two right there.
Is that German? Allie, you know, do you want to be my Valentine? Because I ain't got a Valentine. Yeah.
Sure.
No, you're supposed to say no.
Colin, whatever Dominic said didn't work. I didn't get a Valentine's Day, and I'm tired of it.
You need to teach me how to get a Valentine. Please, Colin.
One simple step, Blake. Be yourself.
Nani?
Oh, God. Come on, Blake. Do you have something you want to say?
do you want to be my Valentine?
Yes.
I guess all I had to do was be myself, just like Colin said, and everything worked out in the end.
Hey, Boerne High School, it's Blake Taylor. We had a lot of fun today. Asked some girls to be our Valentines. Hey, didn't get the result we wanted, but it all worked out in the end. As Valentine's season approaches, you just gotta remember, be yourself, be respectful, and you know, if she doesn't like you back, no shame in it. Just gotta keep rolling with the punches and just have a groovy Valentine's Day, man. Thanks, Boerne High School.
And that's it for this week's edition of BHNN. I'm Carson.
I'm Bailey, and we'll see you next time.